Good afternoon. Let's now revise what did we say yesterday for the radian measure. As I told you, for the radian, it's a unit for measure the rotation. I can use a degree and I can use a radian. If I used, if I'm talking about squares, triangles, I have to use the degree. And if I used the circle, I can use degree and radian. Now, but before start with let's remind you how to convert from degree to radian and how to convert from radian to degree. If we have it as a degree to radians, you have to multiply it by pi over 180 and to radian from radians to degree by 180 over pi. Now, before continue, I just remind you, did you remember now what is the radius of the circle? How can we find how can we find the circumference of the circle?
It's 2 pi.
2 pi r or 2 pi.
Exactly. So let's draw here a circle. Now I want here before I start to continue. How from where they bring that the half of the circle is pi, and the full circle is 2 pi. From where they bring it?
180, I think.
No, so look here. Now we have a circle, and this is the unit circle that we have to use it to find the sine, cosine for any angle. Now, all of us know that to find the circumference of the circle, we have to say 2 pi times the radius. So if I want now to find the measure of this sector here, this is a sector. And this sector is a proportion from the full circle. So as you see here, this arc is it's a quarter from the circle. So if I want to find its circumference for this arc here, I have to multiply it by 1/4. Why 1/4? Because it's a quarter from a circle. So 1/4 times 2 pi r. You know what is r radius, and pi we know it from 3.14 or 22/7. This is pi. Then,
teacher, yes. You said it's 1/4 because it has 4 parts. So
exactly like the fractions. I need to find this one here that. The length of this sector here, or the circumference of it. So I multiply by 1/4. So 1/4 times 2 times pi. And since I'm talking about a unit circle, so what is the radius of the unit circle? It is 1. Right. So if you cancel here, you will find that the length of this part here is pi/2. That's why here they assume that as the angle 90 is pi/2. And then if you want to find this one, the half of the circle, what you have to do here, you have to multiply by half. So it will be pi times the radius, which is pi. That's why here, this angle here is pi. So the measure of this angle starting from this initial side up to this side will be pi. And if I want to find the measure of this circle starting from this point, up here, the full circle. I have to find the circumference of the circle. So what is the circumference of the circle? Which is 2 pi r. And since the radius is 1, so it will be 2 pi. That's why here, after the circumference of the circle, they found that at point zero is at full of the circle, 2 pi. Quarter of the circle, pi/2. Half of the circle, pi. Then they ask yourself, if this is pi, and in degree, it is 180. So how can I convert this by to 180? You ask yourself, I have it in radian and I want to convert it to degree. So what you have to do here, you ask yourself that I have 180 over by. It is, if I make this step, I will convert it to 180. So after they have this information, that the scientist asked herself, that if I multiply any radian angle by 180 over by, I can find 180. How did you remember in chapter 9 in algebra 2, how can we ask if I have numbers, how can we find the formula that if I apply or if I substitute, sorry, any number on it, I can find y? You create an equation. Here also they create a formula. You create a formula and you here and you can't create a formula. Then they ask yourself, so that means any angle in the unit circle, if you want to find it or write it in radian, just multiply it by 180 over by.
Okay, teacher, thank you.
Okay, yeah. So this is here, so they found that. So this is by, which is 180. So to convert any radian angle, just multiply by 180 over by. Now, after that, let's come back now. All of us, we have to use the calculator. What we can we? How can we solve it? How can we find it? How can we use the radian using the calculator? Just 1 second, please. Here.
Teacher, you mean just to convert it to degree?
Yes. How? No. Here, I just. Yes. Just 1 second, please.
Okay.
Here now, did you see the calculator now?
Yeah.
Okay. Here now, I want you to tell you how can we find the, how can you use the radian in calculator? Now, here we have, just 1 second, please. Let's turn it on. Now, did you see here, what is the letter? Hello. Okay. Number one. Okay. Now, did you see here what is the letter is? The small one here?
Yeah, R.
This R, it's mean radian. So, if I want to find it, to find sine pi over 4, as an example, pi over 4, or as an example, pi. We know pi is 180. I need to find its sine. I don't want to convert it to a degree and then find its sine. I want to use my calculator. So just to press sine, then shift by over 4. So if you write it here as sine by over 4, the calculator will understand that you are talking about radian. So this by, which is mean by over 4 as a radian angle. So if you tell her equal, they will tell you that the square root of 2 over 2, which is the sine of 45.
Yeah, teacher, if I had my answer, like if I wrote my answer in decimals, not in square root of 2 over 2, is it right?
Yes, it's the same.
Okay. But teacher, how can we convert it to R?
Okay, look here, this is the SD here. Wait a minute, just a second. Here.
Yeah, mine is the
SD. SD.
Oh, no, I don't have
it. Okay. If you press on it here, just 1 second. This comes like fraction. Press on it. It's right for you as a decimal.
Yeah, but because I don't have it, so I just use it as decimals.
Okay, there's no problem.
Okay. But teacher,
how can we put the R because it's not working?
Just 1 second. I want to see something. So now look at here. If you write it as pi over 4 in the radian, they told you that it is 1 over 4 times pi, but they understand pi as 3.14. because no, halas, pi over 4 is pi over 4. Hello, if you want to convert it, I think there's a way, if you see the watch the videos, there's a way how to convert radian to degree. You have to write the angle, then save it on the calculator. Then you write pi over 4, letter D. That's me, and convert to degree, they write to degree. But I think it's better for you to use your mind. Now, so this is here in radian. So if you want to find the sine or cosine in radian for pi over 4, be careful. That's your calculator now in radian. But what would we have if we have it in degree now? To convert it, shift. I have to see here how to convert it because I don't have this. Hello. For this calculator here, shift and menu here, now shift. Alpha.
Teacher, shift or alpha?
It's shift and mode set up.
Ah, yes, shift and menu here. Then did you see now number two? This is mean. Choose two. Then you have one as a degree, two as a radian. I want that as a degree, so press number one. So here now the letter, that's we have it as D. This is mean degree. So that's why sometimes when you send me in the WhatsApp, teacher, why does the sign that I have is different than what you wrote? Because your calculator is in radian. So if you write in radian sine 30, it didn't give you 1/2. Because this 30, they understand it as the 30 radian. It's not as a 30 degree. So here now we have it as D. So we have it as a degree. Don't write sine pi over 4. Because if you write it as pi over 4, they will understand it as 3.14 over 4. If you are in degree, they understand it as a 3.14 over 4. The pi that we use it to find the circumference of the circle. So let's see here. If you use it as sine pi over 4, and we know that it is, in radian, it is 45. So the answer must be square root of 2/2. Let's see here now, if you use it in degree, they give me another number. So anyway, if you are in degree, write it as sine. Where's sine? Sine 45. This will give you the answer because you are in degree. So if you are in degree, if you have letter D, use it as the degrees. If you have it as a radian, write by 2 as you want.
Teacher, you said we to convert it to R, make it shift and menu set up.
In this calculator, yes, shift and menu. You have to write it. You have here the angles. And in my calculator here, in the calculator, the
you calculator. You want to tell me how to convert them. It was like yours.
Hello, what did you have, Casio FX991ESNT?
I have just shift alpha and mode.
Hello, shift mode. Then you have it now as number one, math IO, number
I have
two line.
One, two, three. Only.
Yeah?
I have one SCL, two mode, three all.
Try mode, number two.
Okay. It just says mode clear.
So what did you have in number one?
Wait, I have SCL, which is static clear.
So number three.
Reset all. The teacher, I will send it to you to the WhatsApp because I know that you sent it once to me. I'll send it to you in the WhatsApp.
Okay. You other one is don't have a calculator. I need me to send you the link. Tell me, okay? I will send you for link to install it on the your laptop. This one here.
Yeah, teacher, we should use the calculator, right?
Oh, yes, yes.
Okay.
So this is here how to find the sine in radian if you have calculator, and how to find it in degree. So pi here is a 3.14 in degree. And if you write it in the radian, they understand it as 180. Is it clear now?
Yes.
Yes. Yeah.
Now, let's come back. So let's continue here now. Negative pi. I want to see now where is angle negative pi. Negative pi, and this is an radian. So we have to multiply it by 180 over pi. So we have it as negative 180. Then negative 180, this is zero. Zero, negative 90, negative 180, negative 270. So where is the angle of negative 180 or negative pi?
It's in the negative x-axis.
It is in the negative x-axis. Is it clear?
Yes, teacher, thank you.
Yes.
Yeah.
Now, let's find 6 pi over 5. I want to cancel pi. So by 180 over pi.
Over radian. Yeah.
Then divide by, how can I simplify it here? Divide by 5 is 1. Divide by 5 is 22, I think. Just 1 second, please. Yeah, 36, yes. So it's has to be.
Find that
36 times 6, which is 260. So 6 pi over 5 in radian is 216 in degree. Then here, I want now to represent it. So this is the circle that I have. So we say that the answer was 216. So this is 0. 90, 180, 270, and I have 216, so which is will be here. So in which quadrant now? 6 pi over 5 in quadrant 3.
Teacher?
Yes.
Teacher, like if they say sketch the angle that has 660, it has like more than 2 rotations, right?
Yes.
So I will start by saying 360, then 660, then plus 90, plus 90, right?
Yeah, 360 plus 90, then plus 90, then plus 90. So it will be like 300. Yeah, you have to subtract.
Yeah, the other last one will be 630.
It is 660, right? The angle is 660?
Yeah.
So in your mind, just say that I'm starting from 360. So subtract 660 minus 360, which is 300. So that's mean if you are starting from 360, you have to go up to 300 degrees to reach it here.
Oh, only like that?
Yes.
Okay. Okay, thank you, teacher.
Yeah. Now,
teacher, I noticed that most of them can be solved without converting, because like if I say 4 pi over 3 radians, it's like saying pi plus pi over 3, and both of them are the famous radian angles. So we can know them without converting.
Can you repeat? What did you tell you? Please repeat. If you have 4 pi over 3, how do you convert that?
Like I can say that it's like saying pi plus pi over 3, and that means it's like 180 plus 60, and then I'll just add them without converting.
Yes, I will give you another easier one. And I just, when I want to convert, I didn't use this formula. And I just see, so say that 4 pi Oh, you know that 4 over 3 is it 1 over 3 plus 3 over 3 times pi. So it is like pi plus pi over 3. That's mean 180 plus 60, which is 240. This is, so for me as an example, if I want in my mind, like if I have pi over 5 as an example, just I divide 180 over 5, and I just replace 180 with pi. Then I would say 180 over pi, 36. If you have it as pi over 2, and in my mind, I will say 180 over 2, which is 90. And if I want, if I have it as 270, okay, I want to convert it to radian. Just I divide it by 180. Then I simplify as divide by, sorry, divide by 90 is 2, divide by 90 is 3. So I have it as a 3 by over 2. So you have many ways you can convert from radian to degree and from degree to radian. But as I have to tell you the origin. In order to find how to convert it.
Okay.
Now, the last thing, but I remember to tell you about it, that if you have the answer, the angle in radian, you want to write it in degree, you have to write it as a number. And if you have it in a degree and you want to write it as a radian, you have to keep it with pi. So what does it mean? If you have the angle like 3 degrees, you want to write it, and you have 3 radians now. If you have a 3 degrees, you have to say 3 times pi over 180, so which is a 3 over, a pi over 60. And keep it as pi, because I want the answer in radian. And in radian, we must have the answer with pi. If we have it as a degree, you must write it as a number. So what does it mean? Here we have 3 radians. To convert radian to a degree, you have to multiply it by 180 over pi. So when you write it, you have to 3 times 180, 260 plus 180, I think 540. Just 1 second, okay. Yeah, so we have it as 540 over pi. I want the answer as a degree, so don't keep it over pi. Divide it by 3.14 to write the degree as 171.9 degree.
Teacher, pi equal to point what?
3.14.
Oh, okay. Thank you.
Or 22 over 7. Anyways. So I will repeat. If I give you an answer in the question in degree, you want to write it as a radian, you have to keep pi. But if you have it in radian and you want to write it in degree, you have to write it as a number.
Okay, teacher.
Okay. Now, let's come here now. Now, as here, you don't have the calculator and you want to find the cosine and sine of radian measure. Now, by the way, these lessons, sometimes you can't solve the questions with calculator, but next in chapter 14, you must know how to solve them, because even though you use the calculator cannot help you. You are smarter than the calculator. The humans are manufactured or made the calculator. So sometimes they give you the answer as negative 40. As an example, the angle is negative 40. But don't write it for me as a negative 40. You have to think that negative 40, it's mean 320. So you have to use your mind. And these questions, it's okay. You can use the calculator. But next lessons in chapter 14, as I told you, the calculator cannot help you. Here now, you don't have the calculator. Yes. For these lessons, you can use the calculator in order to find the answer. Here now you have pi over 4 in radians. You want to find its cosine and its sine. Now, what you have to do first, you can use the calculator, as I told you, enter radian, then write sine pi over 4, or if you don't have the radian, if you want to have only the degree, what you have to do? The first step, you have to convert degree, radian to degree. After that, find the sine or the cosine of the degree angle, of the angles in degree. So here, cosine pi over 4. So the first step, you have to convert pi over 4. Pi over 4 times 180
over pi,
which will be 45 degree. After I convert it, I have to find the sine and the cosine using the table that I have it before. So cosine 45.
Cosine 45 equals 1 over square root of 2.
Exactly. So then.
They both are the same.
Yeah. So here now, the sine of, or the cosine of 45 is 1 over square root of 2. And the sine is 1 over square root of 2. So if you want to find out, tell me cosine of pi over 4, it will be 1 over square root of 2. That's it.
Okay, this is easier too.
Do you have any questions?
We can make later, like, to check our answer.
Yes, exactly. Yeah. Or as I told you here, you can use the calculator as I told you. But be careful. No, it is in radian. Do you have any question?
No, teacher.
No, teacher. Thank you.
Yeah.
No, teacher. No. Thank you.
Now, here. What is the exact value of cosine 7 pi over 6 and sine of 7 pi over 6? So here, you have to find the cosine of 7 pi over 6 and sine of 7 pi over 6.
So you the first step, convert radians to degree. Yes. The second step, find cosine and the sine of this.
Yeah, exactly. So 7 pi over 6, here, just multiply it by 180 over pi. So it will be 210. So what's the angle here? It's 210. So this is cosine 210. And this is sine 210. This is the first step. The second step now. Let's now draw it here in our coordinates. So this is 0, 180, 270. So 180 plus 30. You get the degree, the angle, sorry, of 210. So if you add 180 to 30, you can draw 210. Then you have to find the sine and the cosine for them. Ask yourself now, for the cosine of 30 and sine of 30, what is the cosine of 30?
Square root of 3 over 2, but it should be negative, right?
But before that, it's square root of 3 over 2, and the sine, it's 1 over 2. This is the first step. Then, where is my 30? It is in a quadrant 3, and in a quadrant 3, as I told you, only the tan is positive. So the cosine and the sine are negative.
Teacher?
Yes.
Can I make it cosine 210?
In calculator.
Yeah.
In calculator, yes. But now you don't have calculator. You have only the numbers that they are in the table.
Okay, teacher.
Okay. And if you use calculator, it will give you this answer, that the cosine is negative 3 square root of 3 over 2. And the sine is negative half.
Okay.
But why I give them Now, later on, when you want to solve, when you solve equations in lesson two, I can give you that the sine of the angle is negative half. So try it now in calculator. Sine inverse of negative half. What the answer will be? Negative 30.
It's negative 30.
So what is this negative 30? You have to ask yourself now. Negative 30, and you, that's mean the sine is up round from the 180 30 degree and from 360 with 30 degree. So then, and the sine is negative at the quadrant 2 and the quadrant 3. So when you solve it, you have to tell me it could be 210 and it could be 330. That's why here you must
repeat this one.
Lala, this is in lesson two. In chapter, later on, we're going to talk about them. But that means, that just to tell you, that the calculator cannot help you in everything. Yani, okay, it's telling me that cosine 210 is negative square root of 3 over 2. But when I told her, give me the sine inverse of negative half, it will not give you 210. You have to use to your mind to find this 210.
Yeah, okay. No.
So that's here, if you want to find the cosine and sine, as I told you, convert it, write it on the coordinates plane, then find its cosine and sine. That's that. This is here in simplest form. So this is easy, so I'm going to continue it. Now, let's talk about now this things that we take it before in geometry. That's if you want to find the length of the intercepted arc. Did you remember now when you want to find its measure? If this angle is 180, oh no, not 180. As an example, 160, you did tell me that the measure of the arc is 160. This is, we say it on geometry, that the arc is the measure of the central arc. This is what did we talk. Now here, you have to find the length of the intercepted arc, use the central angle. Not the measure, the length of the intercepted arc. So be careful, in geometry, when I ask you what is the measure of the intercepted arc, in degree, you tell me that it is the same as the central angle. But here, no, we are going to find the length of the intercepted arc. What is the formula that we have to use? That. To find the length, just you have to multiply R times R, which is the radius of the circle, times the angle theta. And this angle is in radian. So to find the length of the intercepted arc, you must multiply the radius of the circle by the angle in radian. Not in degree, the angle in radian times the radius in order to find the length of the arc. Let's have this example here. Find the length of the arc. Here you have a circle, its radius is 3 inches. As you see, and you want to find the length of the arc S to the nearest tenth. Now let's remember the formula that we have to use it is S equals R times theta. Now where is the radius? It's a 3.
Yeah.
And where's theta?
Hello.
Exactly. Don't look at the central R, central angle that is opposite to the intercepted arc, which is 5/6. Then, so what did we have now? 5/2. But I cannot keep it as 5/2. I have to find its length. And length, it must be a number. So I have not to convert it. But now be careful. You have to go to convert it. I told you that by is 3.14. So evaluate I now with 3.14. Then if you multiply it now, you get the length of it, 7.85 inches. Not degree, be careful. I am talking about the length of it. So it is 7.85 in inches.
So teacher, the angle, it might be in pi, in term of pi, but for the length, no, right?
Repeat your question, please.
Like for the length, it should be not with pi, but for the angle, it is okay.
Yes, it is angle. I must write it in pi because I must write it as a radian. But if you want to find the length, you must convert pi, but don't use radian or degree. This is not an angle. This is an dimensions. So evaluate pi with 3.14 in order to find the length of the arc. Is it clear?
Yes, teacher, it's clear. Yeah.
Okay, I will stop here today. Tomorrow, I will repeat. I will give you another example for finding the length of B as an example here. And then we have another examples. Please, before I forget, send me any...